In this chapter, we had already discussed regarding the two laws which Mendel had proposed. The first law was the law of dominance based on F1 generation of monohybrid cross. The second law was the law of segregation based on F2 generation of monohybrid cross. Now Mendel wanted to know whether if he takes two genes responsible for two different characteristics will also be able to separate or segregate independently as it was seen in monohybrid cross, or there will be different types of genotypes that will be obtained in his inheritance. So he started with the new cross, and that was called as dihybrid cross. So what do we mean by dihybrid cross? It is the cross made between the two individuals of same species to study the inheritance of two pairs of factors. That means two traits or two characteristics at a time he took and crossed these individuals. So we also call it as factors as genes. So since two genes responsible for two different characteristics were chosen for this cross, so that's why it is also called as inheritance of two genes. So that is about the definition of dihybrid cross. So we will take an example of two different genes responsible for two different characteristics, and that is seed shape and seed color. So seed shape is one characteristic, and we know for seed shape there are two variants present, and that is round and wrinkled. Okay, in P seeds. Similarly, seed color it is yellow and green. Right? So these are the two contrasting forms for each characteristic. Now we know that round are dominant over wrinkled. So I will take an alphabet, and it should be in paired form. We know already about it. So it will be capital R, capital R. Okay? So wrinkled will be small r, small r. Similarly, yellow color is dominant over green. So here we have to write down capital Y, small y. So we have already got the genotypes for each characteristic or for each forms of characteristic. So Mendel crossed the two plants having two different characteristics at a time. Okay, so how we have to write down? So suppose this is the plant with the seed will have two characteristics, that is round and yellow. So seed shape and seed color. And the other plant will have wrinkled shaped seeds and green color. Okay, so he crossed capital R, capital R, capital Y, crossed with small r, small y. So these will be the parents. So now he followed all these steps which he had followed for the monohybrid cross. The first one, he took true breed of these plants. So they were homozygous, round and yellow seeded plant, and homozygous, wrinkled and green seeded plants. So we have to mention here homozygous, since they were pure and true breed. Okay. So next will be gametes. We should know that gametes will have 50% of allele representing the characteristic from that of parent. So definitely this is one characteristic and this is the other one. So in the gamete there will be 50%. So I am writing down here capital R from this alleles, pair of alleles. Okay. So here we should remember that to carry out dihybrid cross, each gamete will receive 50% of the allele representing both the characteristic. Okay. So each gamete will have one R and one Y. So from the other characteristic which is paired, from here I will take capital Y. Okay. That means for each characteristic 50% of alleles are present in the gamete. Similarly for the other one. So each gamete will have capital R, capital Y. Similarly, for the other plant, it will be small r, small y. Right? That means the number of chromosomes are reduced to half or number of alleles are reduced to half. Right? So, all the gametes which will be formed by these parents will be of same kind. Okay? So, now we have to see after the union of these two gametes, what type of offsprings we would get. So, when a cross was carried out between round and yellow seeded plants, true breed, with that of wrinkled and green seeded plants, that is also a true breed, the F1 generation, the offsprings were obtained as capital R, capital Y, small r, small y. So, it is the union of these two gametes, but we should not write these genotypes this way because it will create confusion when we actually find the Punnett square and find out the genotypes of the offsprings in F2 generation. So therefore we will write down in such a way that similar alphabets should be written together. Okay, so capital R, small r, capital Y, small y. Okay, so we have to follow the same pattern when we are writing any genotypes. Okay, so all the offsprings will be capital R, small r, capital Y, small y, because only these type of gametes are formed here. So what will be the outcome? Since capital R is the dominant, therefore we will write down it as round. Also, capital Y is the dominant, so we will write down as yellow. So, all the plants that are obtained in F1 generation were round and yellow seeded plant, exactly similar to the parental one. So, therefore, they are the dominant characteristics which these offsprings are having. So, since here recessive genes are also there, so therefore, we will write down heterozygous. Okay, or hybrid. So, this is about the F1 generation. So, first step which he had carried out was to cross the two genes with the contrasting characteristics, okay, having true breed varieties, okay, pure form. Then, he did the crossing and he got the offsprings all as the similar type to that of one of the parents. Only thing is that here he got the heterozygous or hybrid variety. Next, third step what he did was the selfing of F1 generation. So, what we have to write down here is capital R, small r, capital Y, small y, crossed with capital R, small r, capital Y, small y. Because all the offsprings are of similar kinds. So, these also will be same. So, after selfing, the gametes which will be obtained will be little different from that of the previous one. Okay. But we have to remember here that each gamete will receive 50% of the allele representing both the characteristic, as we had discussed earlier. So each gamete should get 1 R and 1 Y. So we will see what are the gametes that are obtained here. So I will take capital R, okay, this capital R, and small r this way, okay, and capital Y, small y for capital R, and again I will write down capital Y for the small r, okay. So capital R and capital Y will get one gamete, right? Capital R, small y, second gamete. Small r, capital Y, the third gamete. And small r, small y, the fourth gamete. So there are four possible gametes which will be formed by each plant. Okay? There cannot be any other combination of gametes. So all possible combination we have to see and write down the gametes for dihybrid cross. Okay, so of one plant we have got these four gametes. So definitely for the other plant too, since it is similar, we will get same kind of gametes. Right? So based on the number of gametes that are obtained, we have to now prepare the Punnett square. Okay? So what do we see here? That one is round yellow, that is capital R, capital Y, since they are dominant, so we'll call it as round yellow. Second one is round and green. Okay, we can see here P seeds, round and green, indicating capital R, small y. Small y is the recessive one, so therefore green. Then we see small r, capital Y, which is wrinkled yellow. So that is meant for wrinkled and yellow seeded plant. Okay, since small r is present, so it is wrinkled. Capital Y is meant for yellow color. And the fourth one is small r, small y, indicates the seeds that will be obtained will be wrinkled green. So when we prepare the Punnett square and we will see what type of genotypes that are formed, we will see that there are four kinds of offsprings which will be obtained in F2 generation. So we have to prepare the Punnett square for these gametes. The gametes of each parent, okay, we will be writing on the first row and the first column. So the gametes of this plant we will write down on the first row. Okay, and the gametes of other plant we will write down on the first column. Okay, and this indicates the gametes, female gametes and male gametes. So how we will write down the genotypes? We will take this gamete and it will get fused with the other gamete of the second plant. So this is the first gamete. So we will write down capital R, capital R, capital Y, capital Y. As I have already told, the similar alphabet should be written together. Okay, so capital R, capital R, capital Y, capital Y. Then the same gamete will fuse with the second gamete, okay, of the first row. So it will be capital R, capital R, capital Y, small y. Similarly with the third gamete of the first row, capital R, small r, capital Y, capital Y. And then for the last one, capital R, small r, capital Y, small y. Likewise, we have to fill these squares based on the fusion of these gametes. Okay? And later on, we will get altogether 16 offsprings with different genotypes. Okay? So, these are the different genotypes or offsprings that would be obtained in F2 generation. Okay? So, now we will see what will be the phenotypic and genotypic ratio. Okay? Altogether, there are 16 offsprings. So, now we will consider capital R, capital Y. That means, since capital R and capital Y is dominant, so this offspring will be what? It will be round and yellow seeded plant. So, we have to write down as round and yellow seeded plants will be altogether 9. Why? Because we have to see in each squares, if there is only one R and one Y, both are capital, that means it is the dominant species. Okay? So, here also we can see capital R, capital Y. Here also we can see capital R, capital Y. No matter even if there is the recessive gene which is present in this genotype. Okay? So, likewise, if we see, we get altogether 9 round and yellow seeded plants. So, we will mention here as 9. Okay? Now, next we'll go round and green seeded plant. As I had already told you all that there will be 4 kinds of offsprings which would be obtained. Okay? As a phenotype. So, round and green. So, we have to search now where capital R and where small y is present. So, here it is 1. Second is here, capital R, small y. And here 2. Capital R, small y. So, altogether round and green seeded plants would be 3. Right? Next, wrinkled and yellow seeded plants. So, again we see here small r, capital Y. Small r, capital Y. Small r, capital Y. So, altogether again 3. So, wrinkled and yellow seeded plums. Okay, 3. And the last one is small r, small y, indicating it is wrinkled green. So, it is 1. So, what is the phenotypic ratio that we would get here is 9:3:3:1. Right? Yes? So, that is about phenotypic ratio of dihybrid cross. Okay. So, now we will see what will be the genotypic ratio. In order to discuss on genotypic ratio, now we have to emphasize on the letters which are mentioned in each squares. Okay. So, we will see how many capital R are there, how many capital Y are there. Okay. Accordingly, and also the recessive genes. Okay, so first one we'll see that here in this square there is capital R, capital R, capital Y, capital Y. So, same type of alleles, if there are there in the other squares, we have to count. Okay, so we can see that capital R, capital R, capital Y is present in only this square. No other square we can see this type of genotype. So, that means what? It is only one offspring with the genotype of this kind. Okay, so we'll make a note that capital R, capital Y is 1. Right? So I'll just make a cross there. That means we don't have to consider now this. Okay, otherwise it will create confusion. So now we'll see next one. Capital R, capital Y. Okay. So, how many are there? So, here we can see one more offspring. No other square we can see this. So, there are capital R, capital Y, small y. There are the two offsprings. So we'll cut this also. Next, capital R, small r, capital Y, capital Y. So we will make a note, capital R, small r, capital Y, capital Y. Okay, so again we can see this species is there with the same genotype, right? So all together there are again two. So this also will cut. Okay, that means we have finished with this genotype. Then capital R, small r, capital Y, small y. So these kinds all together there are four, we can see here, right? So here we'll write down capital R, small r, capital Y, small y, r, four. Okay, so we have finished with round and yellow seeded plants. So they are all together nine. Okay, so we'll make a cross. Now we'll move on to capital R, small y. So here nowhere else we can see such genotype. So it is one. Okay. Then capital R, small y. There are two here. You can see, okay, which is colored in blue. So we will write down as 2. We'll make a cross. Now small r, capital Y. Okay, so only one such kind of offspring we can see here. So we'll write down small r, capital Y, capital R, Y as 1. Then next, small r, capital Y, small y. So these are 2. Okay, and the last one which is remaining is small r, small y, small y. So what will be the genotypic ratio? It will be 1 is to 2 is to 2 is to 4 is to 1, this one is to 2 is to 1 is to 2 is to 1. So this is the genotypic ratio for dihybrid cross. Okay, so same way we have obtained the phenotypic and genotypic ratio, and it will be very easy this way when you do any particular cross based on dihybrid. Okay, later on the test cross was carried out. Now what do we mean by test cross? It is the offsprings which are obtained in F1 generation are crossed with the recessive parent in order to know whether the F1 generation is homozygous or heterozygous, as it was carried out in monohybrid cross. Okay, so here too for dihybrid cross the test cross was carried out, wherein F1 generation was crossed with the recessive parent. So the gametes that would be obtained will be, as usual we know already about it, that in F1 generation it was observed that there will be four different kinds of genotypes as well as phenotypes were obtained. The phenotypic ratio that would be obtained here is 1 is to 1 is to 1 is to 1, that is round yellow, round green, wrinkled yellow, wrinkled green. And the genotypic ratio also would be 1 is to 1 is to 1 is to 1. We can see here different genotypes that are obtained. Okay, so test cross was the confirmatory cross in order to know whether really the F1 generation is heterozygous or not. So since here recessive offspring was also obtained, indicated that the F1 generation offsprings were the heterozygous type. Okay, so we have already seen how dihybrid cross is carried out and what is the phenotypic as well as genotypic ratio here. So based on this cross, Mendel proposed his third law, that was law of independent assortment. We already know assortment means to get sorted out in group. Okay, so that is when two pairs of traits, we have taken two contrasting pairs, okay, with their varied forms. Okay, so when two pairs of traits or characteristics are combined in a hybrid, we have seen it is combined in a hybrid in F1 generation. Segregation of one pair of characters is independent of the other pair of characters. In order to know more about this, what is the meaning? Okay, we'll see it on the board. So there are two characteristics or two traits that are taken. Okay, capital R small r and capital Y small y, right? So the gamete formation, when it will take place, we know that 50% of the alleles will be passed in the gamete. So capital R is independently, it gets segregated from that of small r, right? And there will be 50% of the alleles which will be present, right? So they get independently segregated. Similarly, the other characteristic also, the alleles will get segregated independently. So 50% of capital Y, 50% of small y. Okay, now what is the meaning of independent assortment? It says that the segregation of 50% of R, capital R, and 50% of small r independently gets segregated from that of 50% of capital Y and 50% of small y. That means they are not interdependent on each other. Okay, so they will get, each characteristic will get segregated independently from that of the other characteristic. And that is the reason in each gamete, okay, which has R, capital R, okay, will also have 50% of capital Y and 50% of small y. Similarly, the small r will get 50% of capital Y and 50% of small y. And that is the reason why do we get these four kinds of gametes. Okay, we have seen here capital R, capital Y, capital R, small y, small r, capital Y, and small r, small y. Okay, so this way they get assorted in group. Okay, but they are not dependent on each other. Independently they will get segregated. So I hope you all must have understood the meaning of the law of independent assortment. Okay, so that was all about the dihybrid cross, test cross, and the law. Okay, that is the law of independent assortment. So the key points what we should remember is the cross which we have done today. Okay, and there are various problems based on the characteristics. Okay, two traits at a time we can take, and there are different genotypic cross which can be carried out. Okay. For example, seed shape and seed color, since we have discussed only on these characteristics, there are different combination of the genotypes by which we can solve any problem. Okay, so altogether there are 25 problems only on these two characteristics. So likewise, similarly, it can be asked for the other traits too. So I hope you all must have understood today's topic. Thank you.